आई एम उषा साहू फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी गवर्नमेंट BYT PG ऑटोनॉमस कॉलेज दुर्ग छत्तीसगढ़।
Hello students, today we will learn about the structural changes that occurred in heart of vertebrates during the course of evolution. We all know that heart is a blood pumping organ. It is an unpaired organ, but its origin is bilateral. During the embryonic development, heart develops from a group of mesenchyme cells. These mesenchyme cells form endocardial cells below the pharynx. These endocardial cells become arranged to form a pair of thin endothelial tubes. The two endothelial tubes soon fuses to form a single endocardial tube lying longitudinally below the pharynx. The splanchnic mesoderm, somatic mesoderm. The splanchnic mesoderm lying below the endoderm gets folded longitudinally around the endocardial tube. This two-layered tube will form the heart. The splanchnic mesoderm thickens to form a myocardium or the muscular wall of the heart and an outer thin epicardium also. The endocardial tube becomes the lining of the heart and known as endocardium. Fold of the splanchnic mesoderm meet above to form a dorsal mesocardium which suspend the heart in the cilium. Soon a transverse septum is formed behind the heart. It divides the cilium into two chambers, an anterior pericardial cavity enclosing the heart and a posterior abdominal cavity. Thus, heart originally is a straight tube, but it becomes S-shaped due to increase in length as its ends are fixed. We all know that basically heart has two types of chamber, a collecting chamber, that is auricle or atrium, and a pumping chamber, that is ventricle. Later on during the course of evolution, different types of wall, constrictions, partitions, and differential thickening of wall occurred. Thus, finally, four-chambered double circulation heart developed. Let us see what are the different stages during the evolution of heart. Single-chambered heart is not a true heart. It is found in amphioxus, which is a protocaudate. A part of ventral aorta in protocaudate beneath the pharynx is muscular and contractile and act as heart. The true heart is two-chambered heart. It is first seen in cyclostomes. In cyclostomes, the chamber of heart are arranged in a linear fashion. Thin-walled sinus venosus, a slightly muscular atrium, a muscular ventricle, and a muscular conus arteriosus or the bulbus cordis. Blood enters into atrium through sinus venosus, passes to ventricle. Ventricle pumps the blood into conus arteriosus, which is continuous with ventral aorta. This is heart of petromyzen, that is cyclostome. It is a longitudinal section. It is showing different partitions or different compartments of the heart. This is sinus venosus. It opens into auricle through a sinoauricular aperture, which is guarded by a sinoauricular valve. The auricle opens into ventricle with auriculoventricular aperture guarded again by auriculoventricular valve, and ventricle opens into conus arteriosus. It is also guarded by valve, which is continuous with the ventral aorta. In fishes, except in dipnoi, the heart is also two-chambered. It is venous heart.
In elasmobranch, that is dogfish or the scolodon, the heart is muscular and dorsoventrally bent S-shaped tube with four compartments in a linear series. They are sinus venosus, atrium for receiving blood, muscular ventricle for pumping the blood to the conus arteriosus, and conus arteriosus is continuous with the ventral aorta. The sinus venosus and conus arteriosus are accessory chambers. Atrium and ventricles are the true chamber. There is a sinoatrial aperture between sinus venosus and atrium. An atrium guarded by a pair of valve. Atrium lies dorsal to ventricle and open ventrally into ventricle through an atrioventricular aperture guarded by a pair of valve. The thick walled muscular ventricle open into a narrow conus arteriosus containing valves in two series. Pericardial cavity of elasmobranch communicate with the body cavity through two perforations in the transverse septum. That is, the two chambers, that is pericardial cavity and abdominal cavity, they are not completely separated. In telosed fishes, the heart resembles with that of elasmobranchs. The proximal part of ventral aorta close to conus becomes greatly enlarged and the conus become shortened. This enlarged portion is thick walled and it is called as bulbous arteriosus. It is elastic and dilates at the time of ventricular contraction. Three chambered heart is observed in dipnoi fishes, amphibians and reptiles. In dipnoi fishes, a septum divides the auricle into right and left chamber. But the septum is not complete. It is perforated by foramen ovale. Development of right and left atrium is correlated with the development of swim bladder as an organ of respiration. Blood from right auricle of the lungfish passes to the right portion of the ventricle and then pumped into primitive lung-like gas bladder by pulmonary artery, which branches off from the sixth pair of aortic arches. The blood from gas bladder returns to the left atrium by way of pulmonary veins, just like amphibians. In amphibians, the dorsal atrium shifts anterior to ventricle. The sinus venosus opens into right atrium dorsally and not posteriorly. The atrium is completely divided by the septum into right and left chambers and has no foramen of ovale. In the interauricular septum, there is no pore, which remains open in the dipnoi. Deep pockets develop in the ventricular cavity. This is the structure of amphibian heart, that's the auricles, and this is single ventricle. The conus arteriosus divides into two, systemic and pulmonary vessel, by a spiral valve. In lungless salamanders, the interatrial septum, this is interatrial septum, is incomplete and pulmonary veins are absent. In reptiles, the heart is further advanced. Though it is near about transition stage, it shows transition stage between three chambered heart and four chambered heart. The atrium is always completely separated into right and left chamber. In many forms of sinus venosus is incorporated into the wall of the right atrium. The ventricle is also partly divided by a septum in most reptiles, and in alligators and crocodile, it is nearly complete, forming two ventricular chambers.
This means that oxygenated blood coming from the lung to the left side of the heart is essentially separated from the non-oxygenated blood from the body to the right side. Thus, in crocodiles, the two types of blood is near about completely separated and nearly complete in other reptiles, but some mixing does occur in other parts of the circulatory system.
This is a reptilian heart showing two atrium that is completely separated, the ventricle that is partially separated. See here, the septum is incomplete and the wall is quite thick in the ventricle. Further advancement in heart occurred and it became completely four-chambered double circuit heart in avis and mammal, that is birds and mammal. Auricle and ventricle are completely divided. See the right auricle, left auricle. The ventricle is also divided completely, right ventricle and left ventricle. The sinus venosus disappears. It is completely incorporated into right auricle. Sinus venosus receives blood from two pre-caval and a post-caval, and the blood from different parts of the body, unoxygenated blood, come into the right auricle. The left auricle receives oxygenated blood through pulmonary vein. The conus arteriosus disappears, it is absent, and the pulmonary aorta arises from the right ventricle and single systemic aorta arises from the left ventricle, and both have valves at their bases. That is, the right auricle have separate valve opening into right ventricle, left auricle has separate valve opening into left ventricle. Similarly, right ventricle opens into pulmonary trunk by guarded by the valve, and left ventricle open into aortic trunk guarded by the valve. This is the structure of mammalian heart, completely divided ventricle, the septum is completely divided auricle, and the openings in the auricle, that is right atrium, this superior vena cava is draining blood into right atrium. From here blood comes into right ventricle pump it into pulmonary artery, and from pulmonary artery it goes to lungs for oxygenation. The oxygenated blood through pulmonary vein from lung comes into left auricle, and from where it passes into left ventricle. Now the left ventricle pumps the blood into aortic trunk, from where it is distributed to different parts of body. In this way, single tube like heart, linear heart, is evolved into four chambered double circuit, very, very efficient heart.